You know, we know that you have won a gold and a silver medal in Rio de Janeiro, so we know where you have arrived, but we would like to know where you started from. We have a slogan that is, life is only a big occasion. Well, starting from this slogan, I could say that after having an accident at the age of 18, and I think it's your age approximately, you guys here, I lost an occasion in life, but I have gained so many others. First and foremost, the fact of understanding very clearly that life is one and you have to live it to the full with your own resources. Now, in 2016, you, me, we have so many opportunities compared to 20 years ago when it was more difficult to travel, for example. And in my case, the opportunity I got was I had new prostheses to start and live again because I lost half my leg. So if I hadn't this opportunity to go back to walk first and then run, it wouldn't have been the same. So I started from there, step by step, as a little girl who has to learn how to walk again, who finds it difficult, falls, then she learns how to walk and then how to run. So the leverage was to try and find a way, find a way that may be more difficult, may seem a mistake, but a mistake considered not as a limit, but as a new resource, as a new opportunity. So it was a way out of a problem. Yeah, each of us has got his own story, and we have a term. I have a term that was associated so many times to myself, that is resilience. So the ability to take a negative situation and find it something positive. So it's resilience. It's not a difficult word.
Come sia in inglese, in spagnolo.
Abbiamo i nostri traduttori perché, come sai, forse non lo sai, ma non ci sono soltanto ragazzi da tutto il territorio.
There are not only
l'occasione oggi di ospitare ragazzi dalla Spagna.
We have also we have not only Italian students here, but we have students from all over Europe here today. We have students from Spain, Romania, Bulgaria, Poland, and so on and so forth. Yeah, I know, because I was listening before.
Avevi pensato di diventare una campionessa dello sport come un sogno da piccola o è un sogno?
Were you thinking about becoming a champion in the sport arena when you were a little girl, or it was something that came out after? Well, it started step by step. You see, when I was a little girl, I wanted to be a painter. And then after that, I've started my sport activity, and after losing my leg, I felt this impelling need, this urgence to go back and do sports again. But when I started in 2010 to run again with my prosthesis, I was not thinking of winning, you know, a golden medal in London 2 years after. But it happened. My dream came true, and it was like very revealing. It was an experience that taught me the fact that each and every one of us, apart from his her own characteristics and possibilities, opportunities, has a passion. a passion that is your own and it's different from the passions of other people, and an ability to do something. So after my accident, I found out I was very good at running. So I took this occasion and I found a new opportunity that seems paradoxical because, you know, running without a leg, it's strange. So your resilience was great, actually. Actually, if we were to find a keyword, Martina, for you, like the students that came here before you, your keyword, your slogan should be resilience. I would like to exploit your presence here, Martina, to take advantage of you on the podium, because I think the students here may have questions for you. So I would like to ask if you have questions for Martina, because we have a mic here at your disposal. So we've got somebody. We've got a question from Armando, I think.
Martina, approfittiamo di te mentre scorrono le slide di alcune delle tue imprese.
Non si sente.
Armando's mic is off, apparently.
Allora,
è stato molto difficile per lei rialzarsi.
Was it difficult for you to get up again when the accident took place? You mean getting up from the floor? No, I was talking in a metaphoric way. No, it was not easy to get up again, neither metaphorically nor physically. I was really very young. I was 18. I had my whole life ahead of me, but not much experience to face what I had to face. So it was thanks to my family sitting next to you, and thanks to my friends, and also thanks to the power, the strength that was in me. And step by step, I took as most as I could from life, and that stage life gave me something back that was very important, because if you face life with a smile and with a good quantity of curiosity, probably what you give to life will come back to you. Thank you, Martina. Could you please tell us what is your everyday life? What is the everyday life of a Paralympic athlete? What do you do day by day? You know that you probably share your experience as a sport athlete as many others people. Sport people. Well, no, actually, my life is a mess. I have so many things to do. What I can tell you is that depending on the period of the year, there are 4 or 5 days a week when I train, when I stay with sport people. I train in Bologna, and I train with other people of the military sector. And my everyday life is made of so many different things. I conduct a healthy and regular life, but I also go out with my friends. And this is very important to remain lucid and active, because if I was only to focus on sport, probably it would be very difficult for me. I wouldn't be able to be a complete human being. We have another question for you from our friends there, Martina. We ask you please to use a microphone, otherwise the internet won't be able to Here, the question. Martina, how was it to represent Italy? How did you feel?
Well, I had the honor to represent Italy and to be the flag bearer to the Paralympics,
and it was really great. It was hard, because when you have to play such an important role, you know that anything you may say or may do will be listened to and watched as a representation of Italy. So I learned to think before saying something, and it was such an honor for me, because it's only one person to be the flag bearer. Okay, there was also the Olympics flag bearer, but I was the flag bearer for the Paralympics. Both blondes. Well, it was just casual choice, and then I have green hair, not blonde hair. In these last 4 years, I got important results, but what the president of the Paralympic Committee told me to motivate the choice to become a flag bearer is that in the last few years I represented the movements also for the values that he would have liked the athletes to represent, to enshrine. Can you sum up these values? The humility, first of all, the humility to reach a high level, but with a low profile, that is a profile able to, that makes you able to communicate with people. And this is important if you want to communicate specific values to people, values such as the importance of sport, the importance of sport for disabled people, because I'm a disabled person and I represent Paralympic sport more than sport in general, and values that are embedded in this, in sport, and also sacrifice, fight to reach a goal, and then finally reach it. And this is something that is valid in our everyday life, not only in the sports sector. Do you have a new dream? Are you working at a new dream? Yeah, I've got many new goals regarding sport, agonistic sport. I hope I can reach Tokyo 2 and 2020, the next Paralympics, and then I have a different goal every year. In July, we will have the Olympics in London, and then thanks to the role I cover, I hope I will be able to do something increasingly more concrete for this specific sector, because now I am more aware of the potential we have as athletes, and we have an ability to attract the attention of the public, because in the last few years many people have become closer to the sport world, thanks to the power that we exert, the power of attraction. And I'm doing actually so many different things in different sectors. So you've become a symbol of promotion of sport through a number of ideals. Before asking you something different, there was a question coming from the public again. I wanted to ask you, usually in the negative experiences, somebody comes and say, no, you can't, you will never get there. Did it happen to you? Well, actually, I can't remember something of the kind. Probably my brain filters information to be remembered. So what I remember of the period after the accident and the all of the period before I entered the sports world, I was lucky to find people supporting me. So probably I was particularly lucky. If I were to find somebody to stop me or block me, I can't remember, because the power probably of the people, of the positive people supporting me, was stronger. So I have a positive remembrance of that period. Is that all? Do you have other questions? Clearly, these young people here are participating to a contest, but I believe that your approach to sport and your symbolic meaning is becoming something more complex and refers to our everyday life. And for us, if we think, for example, about the film sector, many sports have been treated in films, and often movies support losers, like, for example, Rocky. And so very often sport in literature and in films becomes even more powerful from the symbolic viewpoint. If we were to close with a last question, okay, be the winner in a sports sector is a thing, but I want to know for you, what is the meaning of being a winner in life, not only from the individual viewpoint, but from the collective viewpoint? You chose to stay with the people who supported you. We see you with your fans. So we are not alone. And I wanted to ask you, how can you be a winner and not remain alone? Of course, when you run to reach a goal, you also run the risk of remaining alone. And probably you have to listen to the other people. You have to be able to let them involve you without losing sight of the final goal. And it's not only easy to have a goal clear in your mind, and this probably is part of experience and maturity. And for me, winning in life doesn't mean to arrive first, but means to invest all your energies in reaching the goal that you have chosen without choosing shortcuts, because I believe that's not a way. So for me, it was not so difficult, and I hope you can find your goal in life and not to be scared to use all the resources you have to reach the goal you want to reach, even though you don't get to the final destination first, I hope you can be happy in life. The goal is only the final part, but if during the race you were sad, angry, cross, you may win, but that's nonsense. If during the race you were able to learn from the other people, to stay with the other people and exploit your own resources, I believe the final result in this case is much more rewarding. So if you allow me to summarize what you've just said, this dynamics that it can be called solidarity. So, guys, Martina taught us about humility, resilience, and solidarity. That's a great spot. Thank you, Martina.
Martina Cairoli, campionessa olimpica.
Martina Cairoli, Olympic championship, Olympic champion.